Hi there, my name is Benji Yang, and I'm a product manager here at Shopify. Today, we're going to be looking at ads on the App Store. Before we get started, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel to get the latest insights on building with Shopify. So this video will be broken down into three sections. The first section will be on how to set up your ads and getting started. And within that, we'll go over some keyword research ideas that you can use to figure out which keywords you should be bidding on. How to bulk add these keywords so you're not doing this manually, as well the different match types that we offer for App Store ads, and a little blurb on budgeting. The second part to this video is going to be on how to group your keywords or how to structure your accounts, with the difference between having one ad that contains all of your different keywords to having a more structured approach to creating your ads. And the third part is going to be on managing bids and optimizing your ads for performance. So getting to the first part, the objective for keyword research and keyword recommendations, the primary goal for this is going to be finding out which keywords you want to bid on in your ads. And the theme that we're going to go with for this is that past success or past performance is generally speaking a good indicator of future performance or a good predictor of future performance. And so we want to use three Google tools that I usually recommend to app developers who are looking for ideas. The first one is Google Search Console. So for this one right here, what you'll want to do, this is actually going to track your website, your app website essentially, and you'll want to uncover what queries people search that bring people to your website. So if you log into Search Console, on the left nav here, you go into performance and search results, you look at the queries, and this will tell you how many times your website showed up in the search results page, as well as how many clicks and a click-through rate, and you can even select average position as well if you want. So this sort of gives you an idea of what terms are bringing people to your website and their relative performance on a click-through rate basis. What you can do once you have a list that looks good to you, you can export that list, and it sort of looks like this right here, minus this column, which we'll get to in a little bit. It's worth noting that these aren't going to translate exactly one-for-one with App Store ads, as Google Search is obviously a lot bigger than Shopify App Store, but directionally it should be fairly good. The other way to do keyword planning is to use Google Analytics for your app listing page. So provided that you've added your Google Analytics ID to your app listing page, you should be able to see what terms merchants are searching for to get to your app listing organically. So you want to log into Google Analytics, you want to navigate over to acquisition, all traffic, and then change the primary dimension to landing page. From there, you also want to add some filters here. So your landing page should include surface type equals search, so that you're capturing organic search traffic, and it should also include the name of your app. What that is the surface detail tells you the merchant's search query for what they search to get to your app listing page. So you're looking for this one right here, and yeah, this is a similar process to what we looked at for Google Search Console. You want to see which search terms are bringing you the most users or the most sessions with the highest quality of traffic as measured by behavior. You can export this list. You'll have to clean it up a little bit so that you strip out everything except for the search term itself. But this is another way to grab a keyword list. And last but not least, there is the Google Ads Keyword Planner. This one translates probably the least accurately for Shopify App Store ads, but it's an interesting tool that gives you some additional ideas that you can use for keyword research. So what you want to do is log into Google Ads. You don't need to spend anything, but you do need an account. Click on Keyword Planner, and then discover new keywords. So you should have start with some idea of what keywords your business will rank for. In my case, I'm gonna look for e-commerce and the domain to use as a filter, shopify.com. And then it'll populate a bunch of keywords that it thinks we should look into and we should try for our search campaign. The last idea for keyword recommendations is actually Shopify Ads keywords recommendations. And what this is essentially is we generate for Shopify App Store ads a list of keyword recommendations for all apps. If you're new to the App Store, you have no prior install performance, what it does is it'll generate popular keywords for the category that your app belongs to. If you do have a history of performance and installs, we will generate a list of keywords that your app has historically generated installs from. And we'll populate that, and you can kind of add them like this. So that's for keyword research. Moving on to bulk actions. You've got this giant list of keywords, like for example, before we've got this giant queries list of keywords that you could probably add. What you can do is you can add them in bulk. You don't have to do this one by one. You just need to add a comma after each of these. So we'll copy this. We'll go back to our add keyword modal right here. You can paste it in here, click add, and they'll all get separated out like this. So that's the bulk action that you probably want to take advantage of if you're entering multiple keywords from, like lots of keywords from multiple sources. And last but not least, I want to touch on the match types that we support. So we support broad match keywords and exact match keywords. Exact match keywords will match to exactly the search term or the phrase that you are looking to appear for. Broad match keywords will match to anything involving one of the words in your phrase, as well as phrases or terms that contain this particular keyword. So for if we had edit product photo as a broad match keyword, it would match to search terms that include the word edit. It would match the search terms that include the word product and photo as well, respectively. Important to note that these are the two main match types. We don't offer phrase match for Shopify App Store ads. And we have negative keywords as well. So this is used mostly with broad match keywords. If you know there are certain terms that you do not want to be bidding on that are not relevant for your app, you add them as exact match search terms to your ads, and you will not show up for those if you use negatives. For budgeting, ads are run on a daily budget system, much like Google Ads. Essentially, in the beginning, you want to spend within your means. There's $100 credit that comes with new advertisers, and you'll want to spend that $100, get an idea of which keywords or which search terms are driving what type of performance, so how many installs are they bringing in at what cost, and then you want to decide how many installs you want to acquire per day. So for example, if you know that out of every 10 installs you'll get 2 customers out of this, a goal could be 10 installs a day. And if you know that there are certain keywords that can bring you an install at $1 each, you could opt to go for something like a $10 a day budget. This is something you'll kind of want to adjust with your needs as you grow and develop. This is something that needs to be tailored for every business to identify what's a sustainable rate of growth and what's not. I hope you found this video helpful. For more information, tune into the next video in the playlist on how to group your keywords or structure your accounts. And of course, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel to get the latest updates on our products and tools.